Hi all, I welcome you all to the end of the 15th week as well as the last concluding video. Hope the 15th week content have given you some useful information and I hope it was a productive learning experience. Behavior therapy is an approach to counseling that focuses on overt behavior. Rational emotive therapy is an educationally oriented approach that tries to teach a client to overcome self-defeating thoughts. It changes irrational into rational. Cognitive therapy is also a popular form of therapy in counseling. This is true in the case of anxiety and depression and maladaptive behaviors. School counselors can adapt the behavior therapy, rational emotive therapy, and cognitive behavioral therapy approaches when teaching school children to enhance their social skills, positive outlook, and adaptive behaviors. School counselors in the school must be prepared to play a vital role because of the fact that only school teachers and administrators cannot offer help or assist the students meet the standards and to overcome their personal and social problems. By strengthening the professional identity of school counselors, whose training and skills can make a difference for all students, will be given due chance to be developed and established as a vital profession. In the end, I would like to have an overview on the course School Counseling. This course on School Counseling program provides an overview of school counseling. This is a dynamic and a challenging field in the counseling profession. School counseling can be best understood in the K-12 developmental model. In 1990, the American School Counseling Association supported this model in a revised role statement, also suggesting that school counselors engage in individual and group counseling, guidance and consultation, as well as coordination activities. School counselors should promote counseling services rather than taking up clerical functioning in the program. The course also provides information on the special skills of school counselor and special population they serve. Particular attention was given to the role of consultation because of its increasing emphasis in school counseling. Guidelines for counseling challenged children and children with special problems like drug abuse, juvenile delinquency, divorced or single parents, child abuse and neglect was also provided. Researchers also suggested that school counseling needs a change in its professional outlook and to have a professional identity to move forward successfully as a profession. School counseling needs to increase direct services by reducing clerical activities and putting more emphasis on elementary and middle school counseling to maximize preventive effort and engaging in image building activities. Finally, I thank you all for being great fellow travelers in this journey of learning. Hope the course has added extra drops of knowledge in your think tank. Thank you all. Bye.